Polonya'nın en popüler üniversitelerinden biri olan Varşova Tıp Üniversitesi'ndeyiz. Polonya'da Tıp Eğitimi ve Varşova Tıp Üniversitesi hakkında sizlerden gelen, sıklıkla gelen sorular hakkında bilgi almaya çalışacağız. Bunun için Varşova Tıp Üniversitesi Yabancı Diller Koordinatörü Dr. Krystyna Luto ile beraberiz. Thank you for agreeing to interview us. I'm sure it will be a good conversation and a useful speech for those who want to come to Poland.
Sure.
Söyleşimizi Arda ile birlikte yapacağız. Arda, Varşova Tıp Üniversitesi Premed öğrencilerimizden, en iyi öğrencilerimizden biri.
There are so many students who want to come to Poland from Turkey. First of all, I would like to ask you, like, what are your opinions about Poland? What can you give us?
Well, you know, it's my country, so my opinion is obviously positive. But I know that it's seen as the window to the European Union, so that's definitely always a plus. However, Poland has merits of its own. It's already a country with traditions, with a lot of development, scientific and research traditions as well. But also, you know, economic development, etc. But we are still developing. We still see many opportunities in front of us. So if somebody comes here and joins us, well, we can develop together. So I think that's a pretty nice way to start.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is indeed a nice way to start. So I would like to ask you, the Medical University of Warsaw is among the top 16 universities in the world ranking and also among the best universities in Poland, I would say. So
yeah.
Why should people choose the Medical University of Warsaw?
Well, you know, we combine the modern institution with the one that already has a 200-year-long tradition. Tradition is very important, but what that actually means is that it has experience and it has been long established with the authorities, also outside the country, so it is recognized, obviously in Poland, but also elsewhere. It's known, it's basically what comes with the fact that, well, it has this history. But also, right now, it is very modern and we are using state-of-the-art equipment. We have, for example, this medical simulation center, which is a kind of a new development, but students can use it. It's obviously also for researchers, but students can use it to try to get a better preparation for their future career. We cooperate with the best hospitals in Poland. We cooperate obviously with the best scientists and researchers in Poland. So that's a huge opportunity and a lot of resources to make use of.
Mm-hmm. Okay. At the same time, you're the foreign language coordinator, class coordinator. Mm-hmm. So I would like to ask, like, can you describe us the classes in your department?
Sure. So we have courses prepared for those who are going to be candidates for medical courses, but not only. So we, apart from the medical courses, which are kind of our focus, have also general English courses, and these are also very intensive, and we would like to invite everybody to join all of them, because it really depends on your needs. There are students who even change their mind, you know, as they see the program, and then they kind of make more informed decisions about what they want to pursue. So they can switch from something general to something more medical, and the reverse. We have programs, one that prepares students for medical education is called Premed College. It consists of 2 years. The first one focuses mostly on general English, but very intensive preparation. It's necessary sometimes people, just because of their English, need to spend some time to prepare and then, for example, be admitted to universities, right? The second year is strictly medical and prepares for the entrance exam, but not only the entrance exam to this university, because the assumption is, you know, everybody's free to make their choices and there have to be many opportunities. So we generally train and prepare with the focus, obviously, on the context of this university, right? But we also have a preparatory school, which is a separate intensive course, and it's a general English course. And we do have various levels on admission. So depending on what you need, we will adjust. It's very flexible. And basically, everybody can get a benefit from our courses.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Can we talk about the undergraduate programs in the school? Like, what is the structure of basic and applied education in medical departments? Mm-hmm.
So the biggest one, the English division, which trains for medicine, the program takes 6 years, and it's divided into two sections. The first one, 3 years, is more theoretical. It gives a lot of background, a lot of knowledge to then draw from. And the next 3 years are more applied. So this is more practical. This is hands-on experience with specialists within the fields. However, the vocational training starts already at the beginning. So even in the first year, people already have a vocational training. We have, obviously, as I mentioned before, hospitals who cooperate with us. So that's where, for example, students can get the trainings. Also clinics. Also, you know, some new institutions are being recruited every year. So this, like, also expands when it comes to the choices. And, well, similarly with the dentistry division and pharmacy division, there are more and more institutions that help with the training, but we have also, even on campus, new buildings and new settings in which students can practice. So, yeah, well, that's more or less the structure.
Those who want to study, medicine in Poland longer than, like, what does it take to become a doctor after graduation in Poland? Like, is there any exam system? Like, how does the doctor specialization work? Like, can you give us any more info on that?
Sure. So, the medical program, typically 6 years, right? When it finishes, the young potential doctor needs to take a work placement. That's within a hospital setting, within some kind of clinical setting. And during this placement, they choose their specializations. Obviously, they already have information, they have been trained already, but then they need to make their choices. And they also take an exam, which is a kind of general medical exam during that placement, right? When they have chosen the specialization, they have two paths. Either they are going to be supported by the ministry and they are going to have the so-called residency. During this, they train in a hospital, in the hospital setting, they have also tutors and like mentors. And after that, they will take an exam. And then they can look for a job that is not in the same placement. Sometimes in the same one, but it's like a new start. There is also another way, they can do it independently, meaning when they choose the specialization, they can choose also to be independent, find a job somewhere, and still, you know, specialize, find mentorship, and follow the same path, leading to the same exam. And then they can stay there, continue on their own, move somewhere else, you know. So there are these two paths, one kind of directed by the ministry, one more independent. I guess it depends on their arrangement, but everybody has to take these two exams. First the general one, which is called LEK in Poland, and then the one which allows you to be a specialist. Already.
One of our frequently asked questions is that, like, what are the entry requirements of the University of Warsaw?
It consists of questions regarding biology, chemistry, and decision making, which means that it is very similar nowadays to international exams like MCAT, for example, you know, which check not only the knowledge but also the skills and the potential for becoming a really good specialist in the field, right? But the requirements differ obviously a bit from program to program, and pharmacy does not have an entrance exam, so there is a difference here also in terms of, you know, how they do that. For example, in pharmacy there is an interview, among other things, because they also look at diplomas, and actually in all departments that is also true, that they are checking your high school diploma or, I don't know, bachelor's, for example, from another place.
So then how many students apply per year?
So, you know, thousands of people apply each year, but I guess the most interesting question would be about the English programs. So, in the English division, the admissions are for 150 people. Of course, it depends, differs year to year, but there are always a few candidates for per one place. And well, this varies. It can be like 4-6 people, you know. It really depends. Obviously, with the pandemic also there was a fluctuation, right? But this is already a division that has been long established. It's known also abroad, so there are many candidates there. When it comes to English dentistry division, they admit 22 people. By the way, these are not official data for this year. This is what happened last year. But the university obviously had the freedom to announce, you know, different numbers this year. So there are also a few candidates per place, because these two are, as I said, already well known. With pharmacy, there is not that much tradition yet. We don't have the exact data, but the group would also be like, you know, 10 plus, maybe around 20 people, but they also reserve the right to have different kind of admission. As I said, they don't participate in the same entrance examination. So, you know, here they want to be kind of more independent, but yeah, it's growing in popularity as well.
Okay, another question that we have is that, does the medical university of Warsaw offer scholarships to its students, and if so, they do? What types of scholarships and or project supports are available?
Yes, so many students asking us.
Yes. Well, obviously, because we are a European university, right? We participate in the biggest program, which is Erasmus program. So this means that placement all around the world, especially European Union, are possible. But there are also other programs that the university joins even short term. So for those proactive students, it won't be difficult to find a possibility. Because there are placements which are even organized spontaneously because of something happening in a certain country, and students can travel there and take part in some kind of organized action. But proactive or not proactive, students are also supported by our own, I mean, English division's mentorship program. So they get support from specific people, lecturers here at the university, who also have, you know, more of an overview of what is happening in Warsaw, in Poland, in Europe, in the world, and can support and direct as well. There are also a very interesting development, mini grants for students. So those who actually want to do some research can have that kind of benefit of cooperating and being kind of sponsored for what they are doing, right? And also the program is adjusted in such a way that after completing the program at this university, students can also take the American medical exam, stage one, stage two. So that kind of makes it a more international program in application.
What are the internship opportunities at the Medical University of Warsaw? Are internships paid, and does the school offer internship opportunities abroad to its students?
Well, yes, internships are very important during the studies, and as long as people are not qualified yet, they are not paid, as far as I know. But there are various opportunities, and as I said, this kind of database is also growing. So, you know, it's always worth inquiring. Later, when people are already specializing, obviously they can have opportunities to be sponsored, to be paid by the ministry as well. So then it becomes more of an employment, still during training, right? And international programs are also available. However, it's very important that people who are trained here also working here, so that the environment training is in place, right? So it does depend, but as I said, this keeps changing and developing, so I think there will be even more opportunities in the future.
Okay, and my final question will be that, what is your final advice to the students who want to study medicine in Poland?
Well, you know what, the best advice is prepare well, because it's worth it. I mean, as far as I know, students are quite happy being here, and so if they want to be in Poland, if they want to study, for example, at our university, I encourage everybody to come to also our center, take our courses, and be prepared well for the entrance examination, not to miss out on this opportunity. Because as I said, I mean, I think combining this experience with this kind of development and modernity will give them what they need. Whether they want to practice here or elsewhere, I think this is going to be a very good opportunity for them.
Maybe we can ask you, how do you find Poland?
Great so far, honestly, I'm not gonna lie. I'm happy to be here.
Yeah, it's great.
The teachers are great. The teachers are always considerate about like what you're doing, how you're doing, are you understanding the topics right, and so on and so forth. So yeah, I would definitely recommend it.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me.
It was a pleasure.
Maybe you can say we are invited for something like this.
Okay. All right. So we are waiting for you in Poland. We hope you can join us and enjoy staying here, experiencing the country, experiencing Warsaw, and also making the best of the education in our institution. Hope to see you soon here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.